Good day, YouTube, and welcome to another episode of the Albino Rhino Beer Review. Again, we have special guest Jeff. We are doing Flying Monkey's Hoptical Illusion, which is an almost pale ale. The Flying Monkey's Brewery is in Barrie, Ontario, Canada, Planet Earth, Milky Way Galaxy, Universe Infinite. It used to be the Robert Simpson Brewery that was bought out a few years back. They do a lot of the strange stuff. Hoptical Illusion is the main one you can get if you don't go to the brewery. I haven't drank this in about a year and a half. It used to glow in the dark under a black light. It no longer does, which is too bad because that would have been cool. Has a nice cap. It's 5% alcohol. Again, almost pale ale. Kind of curious what almost pale ale looks like, so let's find out.
No head.
Yeah, really no head. She's a reddish brown color. I don't know why it's saying almost pale ale, because that's really the color a pale ale is supposed to be. Which is always strange to me. I always thought, you know, pale ale should be pale, not amber, but it's very floral. Very hoppy. Bitter on the nose, which makes me worry that it's going to be nice and bitter on the palate. Smells like I'm kind of in a garden.
Try it. Cheers.
Yes.
Very bittery.
Yeah, it's very bitter. It's all hops. There's no malt in there. It almost tastes like you're sucking on a grapefruit.
Really bad grapefruit. Yeah.
I mean, I'm not a big fan of pale ales or India pale ales all that much. There are some that I will drink. I don't find this to be horrendous, only because I've drank so many that have made me gag. This one doesn't. I can take it down.
I had better beers. This is a nice way to put it. Still got five more of these. Nope, six. Four more of these to drink.
Four more. It's soft. Smooth.
It's just such a bitter taste.
It. Well, I mean, any pale ale you get is going to have bitterness to it in some extent. It's just how bad it's going to be.
Yeah.
This isn't very... I mean, I can feel it burning in my throat right now, and it's not alcohol burning, it's bitter burning. But I don't really dislike it. I mean, if I was only drinking one of them, I'd be fine.
I wouldn't plan my night drinking Flying Monkey fuel all night.
They have a nice label.
I do like the... It's a fun label. The Flying Monkeys has a lot of colors and everything.
It is a hoptical illusion.
That's true.
I mean, it's telling you right there just how hoppy it's going to be, and it is. Personally, I'd probably give it four and a half out of ten, probably. I mean, I'd drink it again. Not very often. It is burning my mouth at this very moment. And it doesn't taste bad. It just kicks you in the face with that hop taste. It's like, ha-ha, I'm here. Wow. Karate kick to the teeth. I'm good with it, though.
Yeah. Me, it's almost a little too bittery. It's too hoppy. I do get the bony sensation in the back of the throat. I'm going to give it about a 3. You know, it's if someone said, hey, this is the only beer I have, I would drink it. But I'm not going to, like I said, I'm not going to severely on my way and get it. Probably not going to buy this ever again.
Alrighty. So 3 out of 10. From Jeffrey there. 4 out of 10 from myself. been the Albino Rhino Beer Review. Thank you for watching. Good beer drinking to you. I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to chug this or not.
I'll attempt. In the spirit of drunken.
Okay, I'll attempt too, but hopefully I don't puke on my table. Let's go.
Hopefully I don't puke on his table.